is in great part my passion for life. I must say that today I am very inspired, and what you're doing here in DOSPPTI is truly inspiring. And while there are ongoing heated debates on BBL in the Senate right now, I opt to be here because not that that is not important. It is equally important. However, these are equally important matters that should be focused on and prioritized by government, because as our secretary has ably said, this is what could spur economic activity in the rural areas and the grassroots that can really empower our rural people economically. That is also the reason why, way back when I was a young neophyte senator, the Tropical Fabrics Law was one of the first bills I filed in 1998. And if I may be immodest a little, that is what we call vision. So, on that note, I would like to thank Secretary Montejo for this invitation for me to join you on this very special moment where you are actually empowering the millions of rural Filipinos who have the talent, the skill, the artistry through this innovation center in the DOSPPTRI. Thank you very much, Secretary, that under your watch, the Department of Science and Technology has actually embraced and advocated and supported many of my bills, my laws, my passions, and my vision. Not only for climate change adaptation, your project NOAA, but also for culture. Actually, tugmang-tugma po ang ating mga ginagawa. Maraming salamat sa iyong pagpapatupad ng ating vision. And Celia, thank you very much. She's always present whenever I ask for a meeting, etc., to propel, to see to it that my bills and laws are implemented. And thank you to the PTRI, and buti na lang, hindi pa ako re-election sa 2016, and I am not ever running for higher office. That is why I will be there. As Mario says, pupuk-puk the implementation of my laws, especially the Tropical Fabric Law, whose implementing agency is actually not the DOSPPTRI, but the FIDA. However, I always call you together because I believe in government convergence, and that is so important because we don't exist in isolation of each other. So you will hear more of me. And so thank you to PTRI, and I hope that we could work well together. And thank you to the Indian Embassy. In fact, it was in 2005, I believe, when I went to India, and we went to some cotton factories. I can't recall the names. I was in Mumbai. And I was awarded at the time in the Pierre Dashni Academy, if I pronounce it right, for the environment, but at a side trip to some cotton factories, I just can't recall where then. And Javi's represented by Miss Monsi David. She is, I think, wearing a Yakan fabric. And just to model you what I am I'd like to tell you, this is a 100-year-old patachok. I'd like to show you. I do not wear imported clothes, and I'm proud of it. This is from my home province of Antique. This is 100-plus years old patajong. And this design is called, this is hinabol. Well, again, hinabol is all different languages, or different dialects, but I cannot recall there's a name for this. This design is not made anymore. It is very rare. And there's an old family from Bugasong that sold it to me kasi ipis lang sa kanila. I just had to gently wash it, and I decided I would wear it today. It shows that we have had these weaving traditions for centuries, and people may not fully be aware of it or appreciate it, but we've had the talent and skill for so long. We just need to bring it to the fore and to continue. In fact, with the Filkida and the PTRI, perhaps we can, Mario of the Bagtasong Weavers Association from Bugasong, Antique, is trying to revive this kind of weaving style. It's really amazing. It's hand-woven and look at this, very, very dainty. Ito naman ay Mandaya mula sa Region 11. So, ako nandito, nagpupunta ako sa BBL hearing dahil dapat ma-integrate ang mga interes ng mga indigenous peoples at natutubo sa Bangsa Morona. Pwede mag-issue yun. And, you know, when you think about it, what I'm doing is national unity. What do I mean? I'm wearing a Tinggian necklace. Tinggian, the Tinggians are IPs from Abra. And this is also a Tinggian. This is from the grandmother of the former chair of the NCIP in Sydney. And this is from Vice Governor Charlie Bersamin. Why am I wearing this? I am wearing it because I want to prove that I can actually look decent. I hope I do. I can actually look beautiful. I hope I am. By wearing everything Filipino. Even my shoes is croc, but it's made in the Philippines. See? And of course, the face is Filipino. So, Marit Montejo, I am glad that you are here. Are you here every time Secretary speaks or only because I am here? Okay, so you are here. Next year, we will see less and less of Marit. Not because Secretary Montejo will no longer be Secretary of the OSP, sayang, ang galing-galing, sana pwede ko pa rin consultant, but because she will be LGU. She will be mayor. So tayo ang pupunta sa kanya. Okay. So anyway, I have a prepared speech, but I would simply maybe just give you a copy later on and speak about this very important innovation center. You started by saying that the innovation center is simply the research and maybe trial and error research center to innovate. But what we need to do is for this innovation center to be the center so that others, the textile industry, the agriculture sector that you plant the banana, the apaca, the pineapple, etc., will all come so that we could share, put our heads together, so that the research and technology and the players in the industry, urban and rural, the agricultural workers, the designers, this even design center, even the marketers from SITEM, the private sector, hobby, etc., could all converge so that we could use this innovation center. And what I would like to see is innovation centers, perhaps in every region of the country. They could just be the start, but really if we could have regional innovation centers, because the needs, the requirements, and the available resources in every region is different. We have the region of Abaca, which is the Bicol region. We have region 6, where I'm from, where there's a lot of piña and banana, etc. So there's so much that we could do, and I'm glad that under your watch, Secretary, you're able to launch this innovation center. Now, it's very important when you mention that yung mga tira-tira ay nagagawa natin ng fiber. That is so important. In fact, in one of your lectures, I think one of your people in Barangay Nyogan in Tagaytay, there's so much plantations of pineapple. Nasasayang lang yung mga tira. I don't know what percentage of the pineapple is not being used, but I understand that the leftovers from the harvest of pineapples can actually be used for fiber. The leftovers of the harvest of bananas can be used. And apart from that, we know that water lily, which clogs our waterways, which is the cause for inundation in Laguna de Bal, and Pasig River, and Tulyahan, the Malabon, Navotas, etc., and even the Las Piñas River, which Cynthia Villar does, and many others, can actually be culled and collected and be done into fabric as the PTRI has done. You have gifted me with beautiful water lily together with piña or cotton. Piña. There's so much. So if we could also join me, I will help you and I will help amend, or if you haven't put it in your budget, all the areas, let's say, in Laguna de Bay, the nearby coastal towns by Laguna de Bay, and by the Pasig River. So under the Pasig River Commission or under the LLDA of Merit, if the PTRI, because you have the science and the technology to guide the LGUs, the POs, and the NGOs, so that they could gather all these pollutants of our bays and our rivers, and even Manila Bay, and spur livelihood. So first collect it, so you're helping clean the bay, the river, or the lake. and to teach our local communities there, many of whom are jobless, many of whom are unemployed or underemployed, and have little centers. You don't even have to build infrastructure. Just in the barangay hall, just in their women's center, just in their backyard, just local creative cultural industries. So that we will have less of crime, less of tambays, less of small talk and chismis and rumor mongers, and have busy people with their minds, with their souls, and with their hands, creating beauty and livelihood out of waste and trash. So with abaca, with pineapple, with banana, with water lily, with many, many more, with natural dye. I'm planting mayana because you taught me that mayana is good for natural dye. Apart from weaving, we have a rich source of natural dye. I don't have to lecture, you already convinced, because you have it, you have a book of natural dye you gave me. And there's so much source of natural dye, from guava to achuete, to mayana, to actually every tree, every plant in this bountiful, rich country can be used for natural dye, for medicinal purposes, for food, for etc. So there's so much we could do. Indigo, the indigo seeds you gave me, I planted, it's growing. I don't know why in the barangay namatay. Sa akin nabuhay. Nasa same barangay kami. Walang dahilan. Ang ibig sabihin lang dyan, tutok. Pag yung amo nakatutok sa halaman, ay sabi ko, kailangan yan. Walang mamatay. Kundi patay kayo lahat sa akin. Totoo yan. So, nabuhay. Sabi ko kayo, bakit sa inyo namatay? Sa puso lang yun eh. I'm not saying walang puso yun, diba? But what I'm saying is that it's like nurturing a child. This textile industry, unfortunately, as Mario said, it has died. It has been dying. But we can always revive it with our shared passion and vision and action. The time for vision has been long time ago. It's time for action and implementation through the Innovation Center that you have so ably set up. So I'm so glad that finally, after filing the first bill in 1998, enacting it into law in 2004, which at the time my colleagues would say, ito naman babaeng bagitong senadorang to, ang mga pinafile na bill, fabric, ano naman yung fabric na yan? I will not say who, many of them, pinasa na lang itong tropical fabrics law kasi hindi masyadong na-appreciate ko na hindi yan. Sabi, pagbigyan si Loren, bagitong senador. Tapos at the time rin, patang ito, ang mga ina-advocacy, environment, climate change, ano ba yun? 98 ha? Sabi, solid waste management, institutionalization of recycling, composting, etc. Ano ba naman ito? Then payatas happened. And then it was enacted into law. And you know, RA 9003 is one of the most important laws in the environment sector. All I'm saying is that was way back more than 17 years ago when I was a very, very young senator. And now, come fast forward 2015, I see a fruition, the appreciation of my efforts then, which at that time was not understood, was not appreciated. So all I'm saying is that there's hope. When you believe in something and you persist in doing it, there's hope. And you just have to persist. Makulit ako. At kung hindi mo naintindihan ngayon, ipapaintindi ko sa'yo, I will put it in your face. Because I believe it is important. It is so important because first, it preserves culture and heritage. If this is not preserved, if our piña weaving is not preserved, lang tulay of the Tibolis just died, I believe, while I was abroad a few weeks ago. She's one of our dream weavers from Lake Cebu. I am glad that I have documented some of our works. Many of our weavers have died already. Many of our those who know natural dye. So it is important, perhaps we can work together, to document all of the sources of fiber and fabrics, all of the sources of natural dye, and to pinpoint the experts in every time. town, barangay, province, etc. So they is were able to hand it down from the manangs and the mamangs and the elders to the younger ones. I know that PTRI cannot do it alone. I will be with you. And I will make sure that the National Commission on Culture augments your budget and helps you in doing so, since they have a database in doing that. Thank you for clapping. I don't think it's worth clapping about, because we will have a lot of work. It will be the PTRI and the FIDA and the NCCA and the DTI, because the DTI is a program called, as you know, the Roving Academy, where they actually teach livelihood through the Roving Academy. And because the DTI are also the implementers of my other law, which I was telling Sec. Mario, which is the MSME law, the Micro and Small and Medium Enterprises Law, and TESCA is the implementer of my other law, the Barangay Kabuhayan Law. All of these actually fall right in the same place as the textile industry. Because when you think about it, which Sec. Mario already mentioned, this redounds to spurring the agriculture sector. If we wear more natural fibers, we will have a big demand agriculturally. Now our farmers will not go hungry and they will plant more. And what we are using actually is tapon. Then we will have less waste, then we will more use it and we have more income. So walang talo. Ito po ang issue na walang politika, walang talo, there's no downside. So who would not want to join this revolution? It's a revolution of livelihood. It's a revolution of culture and heritage. It's a revolution of innovation. And I am glad that the private sector, that the government, and the legislature are working on this together. So I speak too long, but because I am inspired, I hope that the PTRI, my office, and the other agencies that I bring together with you will continue to work together to be able to bring livelihood to talented people in the rural areas who just need the push, the capital, and the opportunity to be able to revive the age-old, centuries-old crafts and skills and talent which has been innate and which has been passed on from one generation to another. Because for after all, we are all culture bearers. We are all guardians and stewards of our heritage. At the same time, providing rural, viable, rural, sustainable livelihoods for our women and men as well in the countryside. So I congratulate once again the DOST PTRI for this initiative, and I hope that we would see the mushrooming of innovation centers all over the country and of natural dye centers all over the country and weavers in every region, province, town where there are. I can go on and tell you how I veer away from my schedules in the past 15 years, from rallies, from speaking engagements, nahuhuli, nalilate, etc., nalilis ang flight, because I go far from Paracas, even if it's campaign infested, just to see one leader when I find out that there is a... I remember just an anecdote, in 2004, we had a rally in Abra, and it was my part to speak, and FPJ spoke, and all the senatorial candidates spoke already, hinahanap si Loren, sa si Loren, sa si Loren, and I was late, I went to a weaving center in Abra, because I was so engaged in the weaving. So I finally spoke and I told them about my engagement with the weavers. If I can cross the Mekong River to go to the weavers in Laos and in Cambodia, why not in the Philippines? And I've actually done that. Even in Anbay, umakit ng mga bundok doon para makita lang ng mga liliit na mga barangay hall, kung saan sila naghahabi, in Sarat, Ilocos Norte, etc. In Lake Cebu, I've gone to so many of those areas, and they're shocked to see me because they've never seen any national official. And even their mayors have not seen them because hindi mapipuntahan ang isang weaver. Baka siguro hindi importante yung weaver na yan. And they always scared me, my colleagues, my friends, etc. Ang mga issue daw na gusto nyo ron, yung mga walang boto. Well, that's fine, because life is not all about votes, it's not about electoral politics, etc. It's about reviving and preserving and conserving culture. And that's what the DOST PPRI is doing, and that's what we will continue to do together. Thank you very much, an inspiring moment for you.